Hello everyone and welcome back to the Happy-Go-Lucky Scamps channel on YouTube. And my name is Mike and today we're picking up Dragon Age once again. We're going to go for a merry quest. Now, in the last episode, we found ourselves here in Redridge, this little villagey towny thing with a massive freaky haunted castle in the background that just kind of looms over the entire thing. Evil is attacking, or will be attacking later tonight. We helped the militia, we helped Owen the blacksmith, and today we are going to try and find Bevin. So, the quest is here, there's a missing child, and we have to try and find him, and no one knows where he is. So, let's read what it says here, see if there's any clues. Doesn't know where he is, she failed to find him, and told Caitlin, you'll search for Bevin. Right, okay. So we're probably going to have to ask a few people around the village. Or maybe we should go back to Caitlin and see what she has to say about all this. Because I don't know if she will give us some kind of indication as to where he might have gone. But more than... What is this? What is this? More than likely he will have hidden somewhere obscure. Take the shiny plant. Why is there a boat here? Or the beginnings of a boat. There's a load of crates and the beginnings of a boat. That is very obscure. Ah, secret chest. Ah, of course. What's in this empty wooden crate? Ah, a salve, of course. And what's in this locked chest? Oh, come on. Really? Please? Ah, damn it. Right, okay, well, we once again have fallen into the lair of insufficient skill to pick things, so... Oh, well. Let's carry on. We found a random boat that is not a child. Last time I checked, boats are not children. And so now we need to go and carry on our adventure to see if we can find good old Bevin. Watch out, guys! Don't shoot! Interesting. They seem to shoot anyway. I don't think they like me. Right, let's go back in here. Back in the castle. Speak to Caitlin.
Have you found any sign of Bevin?
Hello?
Have you found any sign
of Bevin? No, that's what I'm here to... Jetta.
These are terrible times. Just terrible.
Well, thanks for the advice there. Right, okay, so no one in here is going to help us. Back outside we go. Right, so if you were a small child, or if you are a small child, where would you hide? It's a massive town, so there's a lot to search through. I hope we're not going to have to do... I'll take this. I hope we're not going to have to go through the entire town looking for him. But if we do, then I guess that's just what we'll have to do, although it probably won't be the most exciting episode. So, wooden crate, lesser injury kit. Ah, good, right, we need some more of those. Is he over here on the dock or on the port? There's a lot of boats. There's a sign over here that says things. No swimming. Excellent. Oh, codex update. What's happening here? Lake Callahad. The waters of Lake Callahad are steeped in legends. Ah, interesting. So we're not allowed to swim in there. That's interesting to know. Did he go swimming? Barrel, are you in this barrel? There's some greenstone. That is not a child also. Also, these seem to be full of some kind of random turquoise-ness. I don't really know what that's meant to be, but it's meant to be something. No, who knows. Right, so there was no small child there. It doesn't seem that he's on the docks here. Who would know where he is? Maybe we should... Oh, Dwin's house. You in here? The door is locked and looks as if it's recently been repaired. Let's knock on the door. Is there anyone in there? That is how everyone knocks on a door, apparently. Let's shout hello. Hello? Right, there's no one in there. Let's pick the lock. Let's try and get our way in there. You failed to pick the lock. It's now hopelessly jammed. Okay, let's break open the lock. Anyone looking? Bam! Give it the boot. That surely this door would now be open. Apparently it's not. Right, let's have a look inside.
Wonderful. Intruders. I hope you have a good reason for breaking and entering into my home.
Well, we did. We knocked. We knocked and we shouted and there was no one here. Right. Okay. I apologize. I didn't know. If you would have said, Jesus, what is this?
Apology accepted. The name's Dwin. Pleased to meet you. Now get
out. Oh, well, okay. Well, that was interesting. What are you doing in here?
Surviving. We have supplies to last for quite some time. And my boys and I can swing a weapon better than any of those fools out there.
Amazing. So, we've got a dwarf, a random bald man, and one of the members of KISS is also here. Great. So why aren't they outside, like, helping and doing things?
Why? When did this town ever rush to my rescue?
When did it ever need to? Aha, you see? Logic trap. They will coming in and attack you. You know, it will happen. This will happen. You need to help. Come on, do a help.
I've had enough of you strutting around like you own the place. Come on, boys. This ends
now. Oh, you're joking. Oh, you're joking. Right, okay, so it looks like we've somehow ended up in a scrap. Is there a child in here? Have they taken a child hostage? Is that what's going on? I have no idea. Right, well, we're gonna have to get in here. We've gotta get the big old size nines. Morrigan. Right, strategy. We're gonna take out this guy. This is gonna be our guy of focus. We'll get a Winter's Grasp. I kept calling it Winter's Blast in the last episode, I noticed. So, it's not Winter's Blast, it's Winter's Grasp. We'll get that in here. Over here as well, we'll get Alistair on this guy with a Shield Bash. Larry will get to attack this random thug, and we'll also do our Dread Howl. And Garry, good old Garry, we will get on this guy, because unfortunately, even though Garry is our main character, he doesn't seem to do that much damage. So here we go. Right, deadly striking. We need to do our signature move, kick him in the groin. There we go, bam. Right, is anyone losing a lot of health? Morrigan, why aren't you using your spells as much as we need you to? Let us drain his life. Excellent. Right. Garry is starting to get into a little bit of trouble here, but it should be okay. Alistair seems to be doing reasonably well, at least. We'll get him in here with some precise striking. Hopefully that will help us. We'll do another Dread Howl. Thank you, Larry. Garry again, over here. He's been knocked to the floor slightly, but it's okay because we've got a health potion and a groin kick on the way, plus follow it up with some deadly striking, and Morrigan's helping us as well apparently, so that's good. Then we will leech this guy's life. Garry, don't just stand there like a muppet. Get in there, get this guy. Random thug, dirty fighting. Oh, well then. Okay, that was a bit excessive. Right. Well, we've found a band of thugs and killed them. Let's take what they have, I guess. Considering that I wanted to try and recruit them instead of murdering them all, I think we've done a bad. I think we've done a little bit of a bad. We got a weapon rune here. Excellent. Right, okay, so some good came of this then. At least we've got a tiny bit more money and some more weapons now. Let's have a quick look in here and in here to see if there's anything else. Of all the supplies that they had, they didn't really seem to have that much lootable stuff. Okay, fine. Right, so it seems like we've done everything we can. Let's check our inventory really quickly. We'll check Alistair's sword because we've got a new one now. The Dwarven Greatsword is here. Sorry, the Dwarven Sword. So this does 8.4, 2.4, 2.6, 1, and provides messy kills and 2% spell resistance, whereas our current one gives 1.5 armor penetration, 10% to healing effects received. So I don't think giving him the Dwarven Sword will be the best, and we're sticking with daggers because we want to be lightweight and quick. So, out we go. Sorry that we did that. We're sorry that we broke into some random person's house and murdered everyone. It's not usually how we roll, but it was how we had to roll this time. We were kind of we were forced into rolling this time, and I feel I feel pretty bad about it. I didn't feel that great. Caitlin's house, right? Caitlin's house might be a good place to search for clues. So we're on the case, guys. It's Detective Garry and his motley crew. Let's see what they have here. Caitlin, are you holding out on us, Caitlin? What is going on here? Has she hidden him away? Oh! When you approach the dresser, something moves inside. You hear a short, surprised intake of breath. And then silence. Is someone in there? Hello?
Go away. This isn't your home. This is my home. My home, you hear me?
Uh-huh. Is that you, Bevin? What are you doing in there?
How do you know my name?
Well, because I spoke to your sister.
Did she tell you to take me back to the Chantry? Don't make me go back there. I hate that place. I hate it.
Well, you know, I'm not entirely fond of it, but I mean, it's not that bad. What do you hate about it so much?
Everybody's scared. But they tell me I shouldn't be scared. And they tell me I shouldn't be sad that Mother died. I don't want to be sad. I'm brave. I'm going to be a hero. I'm going to fight them off. I will.
Well, you're not going to do anything from inside a cupboard here. Let's face facts. Come on, kid. Let's go.
No. I just heard you coming, and I guess that's not very brave of me, is it? I'll come out now.
Ah, here he is.
All right. I came out. You won't hurt me, will you? I'll go back to the Chantry if you really
want. Well, I won't hurt you, Bevin, but Larry is kind of eyeing you up for breakfast over here, and, you know, sometimes I just can't stop him. It's a problem, actually. I really need to get a muzzle, or something, some kind of restraining order, maybe. A restraining order might not help. But anyway, first tell me what you're doing in there.
I can't tell you. It's a secret. Uh-huh,
okay. Are you sure? Because we can help. We can do it. We can do this. Come on.
No. I won't tell you. And you can't make me. You can't.
Oh, shit. Right, okay. So, he's run off somewhere again. He was hiding in a wardrobe. He's returned to... he's returned to the Chantry. Okay, so let's follow this up. Let's head back over to the Chantry really quickly. We'll see if we can relocate Bevin after he had a little hissy fit. And, yeah, we will take it from there. Wish us luck. Right, okay, back in the Chantry. Ah, here he is, Bevin. Caitlin.
Bevin said you were the one who found him. I can't possibly repay you.
Well, you can. I'd say... Ooh. I'll take kisses from a pretty girl. Prisses, obviously, being the term for that. Right. Yeah, that's... Yeah, go on then. Let's go for it.
You're very sweet. I suppose there's no harm in it.
Ah, Garry. He's like the regular, everyday James... or not. Maybe it was like a, ha, JK. Or not. Who knows? I was only joking, my dear. A smile will do. Ah, well. Yeah, let's go with that. I feel a little bit awkward about the whole situation now.
You're a kind and generous man. Please, be safe tonight. May the Maker watch over you.
Morrigan is going to absolutely hate us by the time this is over. So, we found Bevin. He's back in Caitlin's hands. Let's just really quickly take a moment to give Morrigan some kind of gift. Because otherwise, like I say, she is actually going to despise us. We'll give her this golden scythe. We'll give her the golden scythe, 490 black, whatever that is. It's like a Mercedes edition of scythes. There you go, Morrigan. Plus four. So we are sort of... She approves of us! Oh my god, she approves of us, plus one. Which means she is neutral towards us. Alistair, do you approve of us at all? Plus five. Oh no, minus five. Oh, well, that's not the best. Maybe we should give you... We'll give you this tribal necklace.
Is that for me?
There you are. Really? No problem. So now he's neutral. Okay, that's fine. What about Larry? Oh, look at Larry. Of course Larry loves us. He's amazing. Excellent. Right, well, at least they are neutral now. Let's carry on. I think we've completed everything that we can here, so it's now time. It's time to face the great evil, guys. These archers are looking much more prepared, much more able. All of these guys are looking a lot more able than they were previously, actually. It's time. Murdoch.
The repairs are underway surprisingly quickly, considering how drunk Owen is. We may just make it.
Bejesus. Right, okay, here we go. How's the morale?
Morale's about what you'd expect. These men aren't soldiers. They're villagers defending their homes, and they're frightened. Since you convinced Owen to start repairs, we're pretty well armed now. That is a relief, let me tell you. We're better off now that we've sufficient arms. I don't know that we're ready for the battle, really, but were we ever? Is there anything else?
Well, it doesn't look like there's anything else we can do for them.
Oh?
Let's have a quick look.
Ask away.
Where can I get supplies? Why have you been stationed here? Tell me what happened here. No, okay,
there's
maybe not. Let's
time before
let's just get on with it. We're going to wait for sundown. We're going to get in here. We're going to have a big old battle against evil. More evil. Here we go.
Are you sure? There's still time left if you need to talk with Sir Perth or do anything else.
Nope, we've done all of the quests. Here we go. We're ready.
Then good luck to you. You'll need it.
Okay, here we go, guys. This is it. The evil is underway. We've got a mist rolling in. These guys are already beginning to run away. Excellent. Oh no, they're going into the fight. That doesn't really look like fighting stances, but... Jesus. Maybe this was the wrong decision. I don't know. Well, we're stuck in the middle of it now. All we can do is hope. Here we go. Alistair approves of us. The quest has been updated. Here they come. Evil from the ridge. It's a walking corpse. Let's get people ready. Morrigan, you can get in here, first of all, with Winter's Blast. Alistair, swap over to a bow really quickly and do your threatening stance. Garry, the same. Don't go over there. Stay here. And shoot this guy. Shoot this guy with all of the arrows. Pinning shot. Here we go. Come on. Pow. There we go. It did pretty much nothing, but it's okay. Right, we're going to have to get in here now. We've got our swords back, or our daggers back. Alistair, same thing again. Swords open. Swords open? Swords on. Shield on. Let's do this. Morrigan, shoot this walking corpse. Let's get this underway. We've got a whole army behind us now. Garry over here, not really doing anything. Dirty fighting, kick in the ass, and we're away. Right, Morrigan now. She's leveled up. She's doing okay. She's got this walking corpse on her nose, which isn't the best. So we need someone to come over here and help her. Alistair is going to be the guy to do that. We'll threaten everyone again. Hopefully we will draw some of the aggro. Right, back to Garry again. We're fighting like an entire army all by ourselves. And Larry here is just stood there doing nothing. So, let's get Larry in here. We'll do our dread howl, see if that does anything. It stunned pretty much all of the zombies, or all of the walking dead. So, let's kick him in the groin while he doesn't know what's hitting him. Morrigan here is throwing spells at this guy for some reason, which is kind of the wrong thing to be doing. Alistair, not really helping anyone or doing anything. So let's shield bash this guy to the floor. That will help to take some of the heat off of Morrigan. We're almost to the bottom of killing this walking corpse, but we could do with a health potion on Garry, and Morrigan really could do with draining someone's life. Let's turn her around, get her to start shooting this guy. Alistair here is doing a good job, but could be doing slightly better, I feel. So let's do precise striking, which I'm not entirely certain whether that missed or hit or what. Morrigan has now decided to turn around and start attacking the other guy again, whereas really she should be on this guy. This is the guy that we need to worry about. Precise striking and a threatening stance in here now. Garry, how are you doing? Right in the middle of the action. That's what we like to see. Let's get as much as we can done in here. We haven't got that many action points, but hopefully it should be okay. Larry is just standing here derping again. I don't know why this keeps happening. They just kind of hit once and then stop. I really need to find out why that's happening. We'll get Larry on this guy. We've got a few of them down now, I think, actually. So we're getting to the bottom of it slowly. Although Alistair is still stood here doing nothing. Do we need to be progressing? Do we need to be moving on? I don't know. This does seem to be a little bit infinite. Garry now, how are we doing? We need to get a health potion in here, just so he is healed up nicely. Let's get dirty fighting. In fact, let's select everyone. We'll get everyone on the same person. So we got Larry in here, and this way, hopefully we can guarantee that we're actually hitting people and taking them down. We'll get another healing potion in here. Morrigan seems to be taking so much damage. I don't know why people are actually going for her as often as they are. Let's get everyone in here. These guys seem to have it over here. Let's get all of our team over here to help Morrigan. Alistair, what are you doing? You're attacking this random guy here. Get a shield bash in there at least before you come over. And Garry and Larry, we need to get you over here. This is where you need to be. You need to be helping out in the fight. Come on, guys. Seriously. This is not the moment to be doing the nothing. This is the time to be doing the everything. Alistair, do a threaten. Become threatening. Be the threatening thing you were born to be. I don't know if he's threatened anything, but it's possible that he might have done. Precise striking now. Garry is down. Okay, Garry is down. That's not the best. Let's drain this guy's life here, and then we will get Larry over here to assist, because this guy has now come over. So we need to take some of the heat off of Morrigan. We need someone who can do a lot of damage. Alistair now seems to have taken out this guy quite successfully. Let's bash this guy to the floor. He won't be doing any more damage to anyone for a little while. And then a bit of precise striking. Morrigan, over here, seems to be doing very well on the spell front at least now. Taking this guy down and then moving on to this guy. Let's drain his life because we could do with getting some of that back. We're on the last guy now as far as I can see. Where's our threaten? Here's our threaten. And there it is. Two people are leveled up.
Attacking from the lake. They're attacking the barricades. We need help.
From the lake, you say? Right. Here, let's go.
Come on, we need to hurry.
Onwards. You there, militia man.
Watch out for others. There must be more of them.
You seem to have a quest.
Watch out for others. There must be more of them.
Excellent. Right, we'll level up quickly. Right, okay. So we've given Morrigan arcane bolts. We've also given Larry some other stuff as well. Let's go down to the lake. Onwards. This way. And beyond. Come on, guys. We need everyone here. Not just Garry. We need all. Everyone. All the all. Oh my god. Right, okay. Yep, we definitely need everyone. Down here. Down into the fray. Come on, guys. This is it. This is it. We've got them all. We're going to take them on one at a time. This guy seems to be... seems to have chosen his person very specifically, which is a little bit weird. Let's kick him in the groin, which is actually just the smallish part of the hill. And now, onwards to the next one. Let's get this guy. Morrigan, can you get a winter's blast in here? A winter's grasp. I'm never going to stop saying that, apparently. We'll drain his life. And we'll take him down as quickly as possible. Move on to the next guy. This one's on the floor. Let's take him down now. Come on, Larry. Now is not the time to dirt. Now is the time for action. Now is the time for hats. Let's do this. Morrigan, what are you doing up here? Get another spell in on this guy. Here we go. This guy over here now. Garry has leveled up now. So we're all gaining level ups from this combat. This walking corpse seems to be a boss. Let's kick him. Oh no, we don't need to kick him in the groin. That's fine, we'll kick this guy in the groin instead. Then we will get deadly strikes in here as well, which didn't really do as much damage as I was originally hoping. Larry seems to be struggling a little bit. We'll give him a healing potion and carry on with the battle. This guy now seems to be giving us a little bit of trouble. Morrigan up on the hill, drain his life, winter's blast. We'll get him down, lickety split, and move on to this guy. Guys, seriously, Alistair seems to be doing nothing. Literally nothing, actually. All of us need to be on this guy now. I didn't realize I'd actually deselected everyone. That guy's down. And we've only got a few more left. Although, there do seem to be more reinforcements coming. And Larry is in quite a lot of trouble here. We'll get a dread howl in. Alistair will give a threaten. Because we need him to be the best that he can be. Let's take this guy down. He's down. Now this guy. Have we got Larry? Is he still alive? He's taking a lot of damage. I think we need to get some health potions in here. No, that's the journal. We need the inventory. We need a health poultice. Here we go. Heal. Hopefully that'll have effect just before he dies. Excellent. It has. Garry here seems to be trying to get in there as much as he can, but... unfortunately, it's just not quite enough. Here, this is where we need a Winter's Grasp. This is where we need a spell to try and end this guy. Garry is nearly dead. I don't really want him to die, considering he has just leveled up. Let's try and get a health potion in here as fast as we can, which seems to have been successful. Come on, Morrigan. Oh no, Gary's dead! He's actually down! Winter's Grasp on this guy. Then another train life. There we go. Garry and Larry seem to be in a lot of trouble. Garry, suffice to say, is dead. Larry has just died. Unfortunately, we couldn't get to him in enough time, which means it's now just Morrigan and Alistair, because all of the guards have died, and I didn't even realize that they were all dead. So we'll get a Winter's Grasp in here. We've got no choice left but to become a spider. I don't think we're going to get through this, unfortunately, guys. I think we might be screwed, but we will poison this guy, and we're down. And that's it. Oh my god. Oh my god, that's so tough. Right, okay, where did we last save? Right, okay, fortunately it's auto-saved here. Let's give it one more quick go. We'll wait for them to come to us this time. We'll get Morrigan in just quickly here. The Winter's Blast, cheeky Winter's Blast there. And now they're close enough. Right, let's get in there, guys. Everyone else seems to be using their abilities better than we are. So, what we will do is we will just concentrate on Morrigan and watch the health of everyone else. And then we will just move everyone from person to person. Let's just keep using as many spells as we can until eventually they all die. That's basically the tactic I'm going for here. Just keep throwing spells at them and keep concentrating on one person with everyone until eventually they can't do anything else but fall down dead. This guy's down now. Let's get this guy. Winter's Grasp. That'll freeze him in place for a moment. Then we'll use a little bit of lightning on this guy and get everyone in on him. Let's do this. Where has he gone? He's gone somewhere over there. I can't really see the one that we're shooting at. We'll Winter's Grasp him. There he is. Now we can see him. Right, let us use another lightning spell. There we go. It's made contact. Everyone here seems to be just kind of derping. Let's pick off a few at the back. Hopefully, we should be able to get through it with a little bit more ease this time. Also, hopefully, all the militia won't die. But that has yet to be seen. We've got a Walking Dead who somehow managed to get past our front line. That's not the best. And now, he's down. So, we'll carry on. This guy over here. He doesn't even know what's going to hit him until it's hit him. Which is around about now. Now. Oh no, he's already dead. We didn't even need to use a Winter's Grasp. Let's get everyone in on this guy. This guy at the back here. We're going to keep taking him on at the back until eventually... Oh god, everyone's losing health now. We need to start focusing on healing. So let's give Alistair a health potion. Give Garry a health potion. And then we'll select all. Concentrating with Morrigan though, as we were before. Larry has leveled up now, which is exactly the same as it happened before. That is good. Let's try and concentrate. Actually, let's try and concentrate on these guys, because this guy seems to have quite low life. And then this guy here, who's now attacking Morrigan. We need to keep Morrigan and Alistair alive as much as we can. That is the main aim. That is what we need to do. Everyone seems to be jumping in. Oh no, we've lost Alistair. Oh no, when did that happen? How did that happen? Oh no. That means that we've only got these three against an entire army of ghoulies and evilness. That's not the best. Oh, we've lost Larry now, which means it's Garry and Morrigan. Garry has leveled up now somehow. That didn't happen before. I think it's possible that we might not make it through this, I'm afraid, guys. Even with as many health potions as we have, I don't think we're going to survive. And... Garry is going down. Yep, I think that's it, unfortunately. It's just Morrigan now, and all she can do is just keep casting spells, keep draining people's life. Although, saying that, I mean, she does seem to be putting up quite a lot of resistance, and everyone else seems to have frozen in place. So maybe, if we keep using health potions, we might somehow be able to make it through this. Let's use a health poultice. Here we go. Just quickly. There we go. Heal up. Drain life. And then, if we just keep shooting him with spells, hopefully we can get through this. Winter's Grasp has frozen him in place as well. That's always good. What are these guys? Hell, right, okay, so we've got a guy. This guy is on hardly any life. Let us tackle him next. I'm just going to stand here for a second. Let our mana recharge a little bit. I know this is a bit glitchy. But at the same time, I think this is going to be the only way we can make it through this. Okay, can we heal ourselves? And cast Horror. Cower in fear, unable to move unless it passes mental resistance check. I don't know whether that will help us right here. Okay. This guy. Let's Winter's Blast him. See if we can take him down. He doesn't seem to be moving. Oh no, he's moved now. Okay. So, as soon as we shoot them, that's when they move. It's not the best. It's not the greatest tactic. But it's working. Somehow. Winter's Blast. Here we go. This is how we're going to do it, guys. We're going to glitch our way to victory. Somehow, this has all come around, come about, and we're going to give him a vulnerability hex, so that should mean we can take him down a little bit easier, a little bit quicker. Winter's Grasp again. He's now frozen in position for a second. Here we go. We're just going to improve drain. Hooray! Right, so that's that guy. No! No, 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 Morrigan. No, don't move. No, how do we cancel? Shit. Oh, no, we can move around. Well, that's fine. All right, okay, I'm going to stand over here. I'm just going to run away. All right, we're going to wait for a little bit more mana. And we're going to shoot this guy with a drain life. We're going to hit him with a Winter's Grasp so we freeze him in place. And then we're just going to keep pounding on him with these spells. We'll use a vulnerability hex so that once again he's resistant, less resistant to our attacks. I don't even know how this has happened. I mean, I've seen some weird glitches in my time and in my kind of gaming career, I guess, but this has to be one of the strangest that I've seen for a long time, where enemies are literally unable to do anything. Okay, well, let's Winter's Grasp this guy. And then we'll hit him with a drain life as well, because we do need to get a little bit more life. Once we've got enough mana back, we can use a vulnerability hex. This seems to be the best tactic to use. And then after he's, when we've regained our mana, that's when we can go in. Another Winter's Blast there. And now we'll just kind of whittle him down until eventually he's dead. I really didn't see us getting through that, and yet somehow we have.
We know.
Kyle, thank you very much, right?
Come on,
fall back to the gentry. Yeah, do that. Right, and we're all back up. Hooray! We're back in action. Right, I know that this episode is a little bit longer than it usually is, but I think I owe it to you, considering that I just screwed up massively. So let's just really quickly chuck some stuff on here. Has that automatically? Yes, that's automatically added to our action bar, and the same with Morrigan. I'm going to save here. Just quickly. Pal. Save. Right, okay, and let's charge in. I'll give you a slightly longer episode. Let's see if we can actually take down all the guys that we need to take down. We'll see if we can achieve greatness through our combat prowess. Maybe what we should do is we should just charge straight in. I'm beginning to feel... Oh, weapon specialization. Each offers a blah, blah, blah. Interesting. Excellent. So we need to find a trainer. Right, let's dive in here. So all of these guys seem to be doing a fantastic job. What we're going to do is we're going to do exactly what we did before. We're going to get everyone in here. We're going to get Morrigan in with spells. Right, here we go. Let's do this. We're going to drain his life. We're going to use that as well. Why is no one else attacking? Because I haven't got them selected. That's the reason. Okay, this walking corpse here. He is going to be dead before you know it. He's down. Right, now this guy over here. We will use that. Remember to use the vulnerability hex, because that is what will give us a lot of advantages. We'll take out this guy because he seems to be like the alpha. He seems to be the guy who's causing all the damage. So let's get rid of him before he has a chance to do anything severe. And then we'll get this guy as well. And pow! Oh, no, he's not dead. Right, okay, he's dead now. This guy next. Who else? Who else is going to take us on? We'll give him a vulnerability hex, so we'll just literally wail on him until dead. And now this guy as well. We can't cast a vulnerability hex, but we can disorientate him and then drain his life. And he's down. We've got a few more guys coming up over the mountain. Alistair there did a fantastic job of just absolutely destroying him. We'll disorient him here. And then dive in on these guys. And this seems to be going a lot better than it was before, at least. We'll drain his health. Can we get a vulnerability hex in here? We can. Let us carry on just literally destroying zombies one by one. Morrigan is nearly dead. I don't know how she has got to this stage. So let's very quickly give her some health. Hopefully that will have effect. Yes, it has. And then we will drain this guy's life as well. Larry now seems to be taking a lot of the damage. I'm not entirely certain why. They do seem to just aggro randomly. And that is interesting. Let's see if we can get another drain life in on this guy before we do a Winter's Blast, because health is what we really need to focus on now. Larry, why are you not attacking anyone? It's because I don't have everyone selected. There we go. Right, okay, now we need to see who's on the lowest health. This guy. So let's take out this guy. We'll get a vulnerability curse on him. And then destroy him as best we can. Now this guy, who seems to have taken some damage from the soldiers around. Let's take him out. There we go. He's down. Now this guy. Winter's Blast. That's what we need. We've got a lot more soldiers, a lot more undead soldiers who have kind of come in here from seemingly nowhere, actually. And he's down. Larry is in serious need of some kind of health potion, so we'll give him our last health poultice. Hopefully that will take... Oh, no, it didn't take effect. That's not the best. Alistair, then. We need to give him the health because he is the one who is suffering the most. So it's just us now. We'll focus on Morrigan, as we have been. I'm not entirely certain how well this is going to go down now, though. We do still have Alistair, at least. That's something that we can hold on to. But these guys, they just seem relentless. There's just no stopping to it. Alistair and Morrigan on the lowest health here. As far as I can see, at least, anyway. Let's try. I'll tell you what. We might have... Oh, no, we can't even run away and regroup. In fact, yes, we can. I'm sure we can. Let's quickly drain his life and then carry on running away. We'll just run up this mountain here and we'll bring everyone with us as best as we can. Right, I think we're out of the way a little bit more now. Do we have a health kit? Yes, we do. We've got some health. We'll give Morrigan some health. We'll give Alistair some health. And hopefully that'll be enough for now. But who knows? We'll drain this guy's life again. We've got a load of people who we need to take down. I'm not certain whether we're going to get through this, actually. Looking at the state of affairs, we're literally drinking our way through all of our health potions now. We don't have that many left either in terms of, like, injury kits, so let's try and focus on the weakest, which is nothing. Actually, there's no one who is any weaker than any of the other ones. So let's try as best we can to take out them one by one, like we were doing before. Garry now isn't going to last very long, unfortunately. And he's down, which means it's just Morrigan and Alistair now. Drain life, which has taken out this guy. But now, we're in a spot of bother. Alistair just isn't attacking anyone again. This is an unbelievably annoying glitch now. Alistair is going to go down, I think, now. Morrigan is most definitely down. And there's very little we can do apart from run away. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to run away. All of those ones down there seem to have... What? Oh, God. Okay, running away doesn't work. Phew. Oh, my God. Well... Well, that's not the best. Right, so I'm afraid, guys, we're officially out of time. So, I don't really know what to say. This is unbelievably tough. So, thank you very much for watching, guys. Stay tuned for the next episode of Dragon Age, where we attempt to take out some of these giant evil beasties, and hopefully next time we'll be able to get through the undead army and seal victory and find the girl in the castle. But until then, guys, like I say, thank you very much for watching. I've been Mike of the Happy-Go-Lucky Scamps, and I will see you in the next one. So, take care, guys. Bye-bye.